Today we are going to be booting up the Odroid H3 Plus for the very first time. And we're going to take a look at the BIOS and get Windows 11 installed upon it. I'm going to leave all the defaults as they are set in the BIOS, but we're going to step through some of the options in here to highlight where you might want to amend settings for your particular use of an Odroid. At the bottom of the main section is where you can set the system language and the system date and time if you wish to set it in here in the BIOS. In the power and performance section, this is where you can configure the amount of power your processor uses and allow it to use Turbo Boost. By default, the power limit floor setting is 30,000, which equates to 10 watts. If you change this to either 0 or 48,000, then this will allow the CPU to use 16 watts and give you the turbo mode indefinitely, assuming you have a fan to keep the heatsink working optimally. This gives you 2.6 GHz on all cores and 2.9 GHz on one core for the H3, and 2.8 GHz on all cores and 3.3 GHz on one core for the H3 Plus. Next, we will look at the chipset, as there is something in here that may be of interest. As well as the Wacom LAN option, there is the State After G3 setting, which specifies what your Odroid will do when the power is reapplied after a power cut. The latest BIOS doesn't make this too clear, but I've added a screenshot from the H2 BIOS which does make it clearer. When you have this set to S0, the system will boot directly as soon as the power is reapplied. If it is set to S5, then the system keeps in power off state until you press the power button. This would allow you to auto boot your Odroid when the power is restored, should a power cut occur, allowing you to have, for example, a web server or IoT device recover following a power outage. We have, of course, the administrator's password in the security section. It's always good to set that. And the secure boot. The ability to use TPM is enabled by default, so installing Windows 11 isn't going to be a problem. As we haven't made any changes to the BIOS, we can just exit at this point. Now we can start the process to reboot and install Windows 11 on the Odroid. I'm not going to show the whole Windows 11 install, as you've probably seen it all before, and it isn't any different on the Odroid H3 Plus. Suffice to say that once Windows 11 is installed, it correctly shows up as a Pentium Silver N6005 running at 2 GHz, because at the moment we haven't changed it to turbo mode. It's showing correctly as having 16 GB of memory, and we've installed Windows 11 Pro on it. So all I need to do now is to install the software I want to install on this machine and then start using it. However, that's it for today. Thank you for watching.